So we know every employee.
Okay, how about we just keep an eye on that speech and I'll let you know if anything important happens. What is happening right now? Take a look at this, though. The Dow has now crossed 800 points to the downside. That is a loss of greater than 3%. Markets are now down more than 6% since last week, but this is much bigger than last week's losses. We're going to be following this very, very closely. The S&P 500 has also plummeted more than 60 points. That, of course, is going to look more like your 401k, but it is now down more than 5% from its high on January 22nd, because so much of investment is expectations. We sort of knew that the Fed was looking to increase rates, let's call it three times in 2018, generally speaking, a quarter of a percentage point each time. So three 25 basis point increases, 75 basis points, 75 one-hundredths of a percent. Now we think the economy is going gangbusters, and maybe, we don't have certainty on it, but maybe they do one more. So they take interest rates one full percentage point higher. Now, if I'm about to sign my mortgage, that would annoy me. But the bottom line is, historically, our interest rates right now are very low. So why does that throw everything off so much, the idea that the economy is doing all right, the Fed's going to raise interest rates, and we're getting into normalcy? Why do these investors not understand normalcy?
Well, I think the
It's not outside. We've all seen it. It's right.
But we haven't seen 968 points.
Right. And I think that's what everybody has to remember, that when you start with big numbers like 25,000, the number's going to be very big. This is, guys, you've heard me say this over the years. Some days I wish we didn't have this board, because because this is what everybody concentrates on. If we could just move this part out, the 967 out, and look at the 3.79, I would imagine 10 out of 10 Americans wouldn't tell you there's something to panic about. But I would say this to you, John and Ron. If you're an investor in the S&P 500, compared to where you were on January 1st, you are up or down? You're up.
You're up a little bit.
You're up a little bit. Yeah. You're up. I just need everybody to remember this, that compared to January 1st, and by the way, January 1st compared to January 1st the year before, you're up a whole lot.
That's right, but these are the days when, for financial advisors, it's as much about psychological therapy as it is about actual concrete financial advice. I was just exchanging messages with a financial advisor who said her message to clients was stay calm, don't overreact to this. You've always got a phenomenon of people when they see bad news immediately rush to sell, or when they see the market as a peak, they say, there's a phrase they use called last doctor in, referring to those amateur investors. And when they get to a market peak, that's when they want to buy. That's oftentimes not the best time to buy. Sometimes a dip like today is a good time to buy.
Victor, somebody's going to tell him that it does seem a little disingenuous to not comment when there are a whole lot of Americans who are panicking about their retirement because the stock market's down. Live by the sword, die by the sword. Kristen Welker, thanks very much. Here where we are, I want to just paint you a little picture of what's been going on today. A steady decline all the way until just before 3 o'clock, and then a very steep decline, getting down to almost a loss of 1,600 points, more than 6% on the Dow, and then creeping up. Investors were buying into stocks. People were selling, buying in, selling again, buying in, selling. You were seeing a buy, and now we are seeing a sell. It is always my worry when in the last 60 seconds of trading, you see down ticks and you see selling. If this number closes below 1,100, that indicates that there's still more selling power in there, which means this could creep into overnight markets in Asia and then again tomorrow morning. This is not a major acceleration, but it has been an acceleration to the downside. We still have a little more to go. Oh, there we go. We've lost 100 points again. So this is a little bit alarming that this is not actually over, but this is a lot better than it was an hour ago when we saw 1,500 and almost 1,600 to the downside. We're at 4.37% loss right now. We were above 6%. That does it for me.